It's been 25 years since the release of Cradle of Filth's blood-drenched third album, Cruelty and the Beast, the band's first concept album that explores the depths of vampire mythology and set the band into a household brand we still celebrate today. Join us as Metal Injection counts down 12 facts you may not know about the 1998 black and classic Cruelty and the Beast. Number 1. The album was detailed in an academic paper in 2001. Published in 2001, Once Upon the Sleepin' Cannon, Literary Luster and Cradle of Filth's Wintry Romances, is a part of the Journal of Dracula Studies, a peer-reviewed academic journal focused on vampires. One quote from the paper attempts to describe the album. In the album Cruelty and the Beast, we find a metaphorical approach to the myth, with emphasis on the gloomy bliss and darkness of isolation, with binary masks of schizophrenia, social, and mental dysfunction. Number 2. It is a concept album based on a Hungarian countess and serial killer. In 2019, Danny spoke about the 11-minute dizzying three-part swan song on Cruelty and the Beast, Bathory Aria. According to Filth, the song examines Elizabeth Bathory's life, her trial, conviction, and subsequent imprisonment in her castle for the rest of her life for her alleged crimes of murdering 600 women. Danny is especially fond of the vocal contributions by Hammer horror legend Ingrid Pitt, who portrayed Bathory in the Hammer classic Countess Dracula. Number 3. Bathory Aria is Danny Filth's favorite song to perform live from Cruelty and the Beast. In addition to being Filth's favorite track to play live, according to Filth, Bathory Aria is also a fan favorite. Cruelty and the Beast was Cradle of Filth's first attempt to create a start-to-finish conceptual record. When reflecting on Cruelty and the Beast, Filth said Cradle of Filth always try to push themselves as a band. This was especially true during the Cruelty and the Beast era. Number 4. Cradle of Filth talk about the album on MTV in 1997. In the interview, Danny and Gian Pyre said that they were trying to create a brash, emotional, fast, twisted, and colorful gothic soundtrack for Cruelty and the Beast. All of these influences and elements would, according to Danny, hopefully produce a fuller sound for Cradle of Filth that would pleasantly surprise their fans. Number 5. Surprising music inspirations. During a 1997 interview with MTV, both Danny and Pyres mentioned they were inspired by English rock bands that may surprise fans. Specifically, Mott and the Hoople, Cream, Status Quo, and The Who. Number 6. Hadley, England played a role in the atmosphere. As a youth, Filth lived in an old house in Hadley, England, once inhabited by Hadley's witchfinder general, who executed innocent women for allegedly being witches using the infamous swim test. Filth said there were spirits that were haunting the house and the surrounding area where lots of weird shit would happen, including seeing things, people, or shapes. These paranormal events would help inform the overall mood of Cruelty and the Beast. Number 7. The alternate cover art for the album. Cradle of Filth used photographs taken by Simon Marsden for one of the many inner images for the CD. Marsden was known for his extensive black and white photos of alleged haunted houses and other spooky spots around Europe. This release, known as the Celtic Cross Edition, has a Celtic cross on the cover instead of legendary image of Lucia Morando in a bathtub of blood. Number 8. The iconic cover for Cruelty and the Beast almost didn't happen. Because longtime Cradle of Filth collaborator, photographer Stu Williamson, forgot to take it during the long photo shoot for Cruelty and the Beast with model and Cradle of Filth dancer, Luisa Morando. Morando, who was already on a train bound for London, had to turn around and get back into the bathtub filled with fake blood for Williamson, and the rest is history. Number 9. Danny Filth found the vocals challenging. Filth doesn't have a rigorous vocal warm-up routine and has never felt the need to maintain one. However, in 2022, he spoke about his struggle with performing songs from the album, calling it really hard back in 1998. Filth found the material just as challenging when the band played the entire album live for a tour in 2021. Number 10. Cruelty and the Beast includes contributions from an opera soprano. British soprano vocalist Sarah Jezebel Diva has appeared on 14 Cradle of Filth records, including Cruelty and the Beast. She has also provided backing vocals for other metal bands such as Therion, Covenant, and Mortis. Number 11. Diva wasn't happy after hearing the final mix of the album. When Sarah Jezebel Diva heard her vocals on Cruelty and the Beast, she said it sounded like she had her head in a toilet due to the production done by Jan Peter Jenkel. Over time, the reverberation of Diva's vocals has added to the overall deviating quality of Cruelty and the Beast. Number 12. The album has been reissued many times. The 2001 reissue of the album by Koch Records includes a cover of Venom's Black Metal, Sodomy and Lust by Sodom, and Hallowed Be Thy Name by Iron Maiden. In 2019, the album was remastered and reissued on lavender, orange, clear, and bone-colored vinyl. The 2019 reissue remastered includes Iron Maiden's Hallowed Be Thy Name, and while the song has appeared on previous reissues of Cruelty and the Beast, this is the first time it was remastered. And that's 12 facts that you may not know. For more great content, subscribe to our YouTube page and like this video.